Good evening. Well, in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to cut a background and how to take a photo or an image in another background with Photoshop CC. So, in this case, we are going to use this background here. It's a wallpaper of nature downloaded by from Google. You can find to make a test everywhere you like. And in this background, we are gonna put this girl here. It's pretty. And all we gotta do now is to go at, we have the background selected, we delete that photo, and go at place, and after this select your photo and take place. Well, the aspect ratio is the same as the background, so we don't have to worry about to select or to transform this photography in the size of the other photo. So all we gotta do to start here is to go at your magic wand tool, and since for us it's easier to select the background than the photo, like the girl, we are gonna select the background just by hitting in the background somewhere inside. And as we see, we have a pretty good selection. After this, we are gonna select some more details inside, and let's zoom and go a little bit closer. Let's select it, and all you gotta do now is hold control key, or no, shift key, and just hit again in the parts you don't have selected, and that will be selected. Hit another color here, this here, this here, and this here, a little bit here, 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 no, back. Yeah, that's all for us, all we need. And as we see here, we have a pretty good selection of your photography. And except this here in a corner, you can always go at magic wand tool and magic quick selection tool and make it corner to corner in the way you gotta do it. Duplicate your background to, in case something's going wrong, you have it a backup. And after this, we are here in this point, all we gotta do to select the girl and not the background, because the girl we will need for our photo, not the background. All you gotta do is to go at select and inverse. That's pretty good. Now we have select the girl and not the background. After this, you had to go at your select modify, and to make it smoother and your sample radius is going to be selected to 1 and hit OK. So now everything, it's almost perfect, we are in good way. All we're gonna do now is to select your refine edge tool and our photo will be uploaded correctly in the way we like. All we're gonna do now is to go a little bit closer. As we see down here, everything is perfect. All we have to correct here is inside in either head and something in her hands. Well, in the second stage, you gotta select your smart radius and play with it to find the levels you like and the levels you need. Hit the contaminate colors and set into 50. Select the brush tool, refinage it, radius tool, and refine your edges. Not in all parts, only in the parts you need to do it. If your selection is pretty good, all you gotta do now is to make this whites go away to make your photo pretty realistic in your background, because those whites are not very good thing to see. As we see here, we have a selection. Now here we have some white. It's a pretty good selection. Now you gotta select in output a new layer with layer mask. In case something is going wrong, you can correct it from Photoshop very quickly. Now just hit OK, and like magic, our girl will be insert in our background. And as we see here, she's pretty good. Yeah, it's pretty good selection, this background, with your details and everything is fine. Well, as we see here, in this point, something is not okay, because the colors here of the background with the girl does not match. They don't match together, so all we gotta do is to select the image, not the layer mask. Select the image, go at your image adjustments, and exposure, gamma correction. No, not here. Set it to 0. No. Cancel. Image adjustments. Exposure. And no offset. As we go now here, we are adjustments again. Well, if we like, you gotta put your auto color in your photo, but that's not the correct. So Photoshop can read your informations, but all that I put is auto tone. And I think now it's, she is very out of contrast, no button. So Photoshop automatically will fit and will match the photography two in one. And so we will have our photo in the background. And I think it's pretty realistic without that. So thank you very much, and goodbye to the next time.